Hello, loves. This is Mr. Willem Pugmire with my friend Greg Lowney and ST Joshi. Greg is a dear friend who is a devout Lovecraftian, and he's also helping ST with his blog and his website. Why don't you explain about that?
Take over.
Well, not too much to say other than the fact that I am responsible for getting the great S.T. Joshi onto the 1990s and above.
Yes.
By getting his blog, his bibliography, and all that kind of stuff up on his own website, stjoshi.org, as well as trying to keep up his Wikipedia entry. So anyone who is following him there, hopefully will get routed to places like his blog And ST is being very forthcoming about trying pretty well, trying to get things updated twice a month now. Right?
It's very hard because, you know, I'm actually doing a lot of work, so, you know, it's hard to take time off from doing what I'm doing to talk about doing what I'm doing. But, you know, it's just that my schedule is very, very difficult. And, you know, I have to confess, I'm not so young as I used to be. I take a certain number of naps. A nap during the day. I have to take a nap, you know. I remember the narrator of The Picture in the House who says, I need a powerful sight of naps these days. Well, I don't need more than one a day usually, but I do need one. So that kind of cuts down on things. And even though I don't have to do a lot of library research as I used to do, because, you know, so much is now available online, I have to structure my day very, very carefully in order to get things done that I need to get done. On that subject, we have a number of new publications that we can talk about. The first, I think, is the new issue of the Weird Fiction Review, which, if you can see this, has a cover that looks like Mad Magazine. It's most amusing. And even the table of contents is, well, you can't see that very well. Even that is set up to look like Mad. But as usual, you know, nice array of fiction and essays and poetry, some great poetry. By Wade German and Michael Fantina, who's been a British poet of long standing. A collaborative story by Willem and Marianne Snyder, who happens to be Greg's wife. That's a fine story. A number of other good pieces. Bob Waugh, Robert H. Waugh, who's a Lovecraft scholar, has also shown himself to be a very talented writer of fiction. I have a great story by Tom Fletcher in here, one by Michael Sisko, my protege Jonathan Thomas from Providence, and good articles. There's a great article on the Houdini-Hodgson relationship, an article on Charles Beaumont, Arthur Machen, great portfolio of art by Jason Zerillo, good stuff. So that just came out. A tad late, but it's at least made it for 2012. The next book I have is The Dead Valley and Others. So let me see if you can show this. The Dead Valley and Others. This is the second volume of my compilation of Lovecraft's favorite horror stories from Arcane Wisdom, which is a subdivision of Bloodletting Press. Larry Roberts is the publisher there. Good collection of stories that influenced Lovecraft's own stories. Among which are things like The Horla by Guy de Maupassant, The Moon Pool by A. Merritt, that's a hard to find these days. Dead Valley, of course, is by Ralph Adams Cram. John Metcalf's The Badlands. Ooze by Anthony M. Rudd, that influenced the Dunwich Horror, no question. That appeared in the very first issue of Weird Tales in March 1923, and that's pretty hard to find. And other good stuff in there.
And the way you compiled this was from using supernatural horror and literature?
In part. What I wanted to do, I mean, there are several volumes out there that profess to be, you know, a collection of Lovecraft's favorite horror stories, and some are good, some are not so good. I specifically wanted to find stories that influenced his own stories, and most of these do. Others are just ones that he happened to like. But I also combed through letters and even through his personal library to see what books were in there. So it's a good mix. As I say, this is the second volume. There won't be any more. I hope this volume will be in paperback presently. I'm doing a bunch of things for Larry Roberts' press. As you know, we started a line of Cthulhu Mythos writing, original Cthulhu Mythos writing, We've done two books so far, Rick Dakin's The Cthulhu Cult, and Jonathan Thomas's The Color Over Occam, and both of those books, the hardcovers, are already, I think, either sold out or close to selling out, and both will be in paperback fairly soon. So if you didn't pick up the hardcovers, you can get the paperbacks. We're also starting a line in that same series of novelettes, or novellas, and Donald Tyson, this fine Canadian writer, has written a novella called Iron Chain that's going to come out whenever. I mean, it'll come out. It's in the works. I put together an edition of Fritz Leiber's Adept's Gambit. This was the original version of that story, or at least an earlier version of it from what was published, and has a few little Lovecraftian references, so that'll come out also. And I put together an Edward Lucas White collection for Arcane Wisdom, so that'll be in the works. I understand there are a lot of people who are interested in further details about my Clark Ashton Smith volume for Penguin. I can offer a few details. Specifically, I have told the publisher that I can get the book done by May 1st of next year, and then therefore it will be published in March of 2014. So we have a bit of a wait, a year and a quarter wait, but it's coming. I'll be very interested to know what they do about cover art. Don't know that they'll want to use an actual drawing or painting by Smith himself, although maybe, I mean, I'll suggest it, but I think most people consider Smith's artwork a little on the crude side, although very effective, but it would be ideal to do it. I mean, if we can find some really good color painting, we had some good ones in that Last Oblivion volume, maybe we can use one of those. But otherwise, Smith was very fond of this French painter, I'm not sure how to pronounce his name exactly, Odilon Redon, R-E-D-O-N, and I think that if we can get one of those paintings, I think that has a kind of Smithian quality to it. But otherwise, you know, open for suggestions, I suppose. I mean, you know, Penguin, as a Penguin classic, they'll want something, you know, classic looking. I mean, I don't know if they'll just want to commission a contemporary artist to do something, but you never know. I'll push for a Smith painting first, then I'll push for other things like Redon or somebody else.
Can you remember the stories and poems?
I can't, actually. But they actually, it's one, well, some of you might be glad to hear that they actually want more stories and fewer poems. I mean, I'm a great advocate of Smith's poetry, but Penguin reminded me that poetry doesn't sell. So they want a sort of 80-20 split between fiction and poetry. Now, the fiction will also include some of his great prose poems, you know, from The Crypts of Memory, The Touchstone, you know, there's so many great prose poems that he wrote. So we'll have at least about 10,000 words of prose poems. About as much as maybe 120,000 words, 110,000 words maybe of fiction, and therefore 20,000-30,000 words of poetry. That'll be about the breakdown. I mean, you know, and it's going to be called tentatively The Dark Eidolon and Other Fantasies. I can't quite remember the contents that I've selected, but there are some of the high spots of Smith's fiction, you know, The Vaults of Yovamas, The City of the Singing Flame, although not including Beyond the Singing Flame, apparently that's considered a secondary work that shouldn't be included. You know, we'll represent his various cycles, the Hyperborea cycle, the Averon cycle, the Zothique cycle, certainly, maybe even Zikarf and Atlantis.
So, are you planning on organizing the book chronologically or based on the different cycles?
I think chronologically, because there are probably not enough stories in any given cycle to break them into those groups. And I think you know, Smith didn't write them in cycles, so I kind of wanted to present a chronological division of stories first, then the prose poems, and then the poetry at the end of the volume. But you know, with full annotations, and they want a fairly extensive introduction, because I think Penguin doesn't think that Smith is as well known to the general literary community as he ought to be, and therefore we all need you know, be more explanatory in terms of his life and work. So that's coming. I'm also very happy to announce that I've recently gotten in touch with Fedogen and Bremer. They've revived their publishing program. They came out with a book last summer, Worlds of Cthulhu, and they want me to produce a new anthology, an original anthology of stories. Now, I told them that quite frankly, I would prefer not to do a Lovecraftian anthology, because I've been doing a lot of those already, and I don't want to compete against myself, and I don't want to be typecast as a Lovecraftian editor, as I've already been typecast as a Lovecraftian critic. I do more than that. So this book will be called Searchers After Horror. Now,
from Lovecraft.
Readers will know that that is the first few words of the picture in the house. But the point of the anthology, if it has a point at all, if it has a theme, is the idea of weird places. You know, Searchers After Horror, Haunt Strange, Far Places is how that goes. And if you read the whole paragraph in the picture in the house, you'll get an idea of what I'm looking for. I'm happy to announce that I've already accepted 4 stories. One by Mr. Pugmire. He just finished the draft, I think, probably just a couple days ago. A fine piece of work. I've already accepted a story by Ramsey Campbell. And interestingly enough, Dwayne Olson has been working with the papers of Hannes Bock, the artist, who left a lot of writing, fiction writing, behind. There are like apparently a couple of novels and a bunch of short stories. And he sent me a short story that has never been published.
Wow.
It's called Miranda's Tree. A fine piece of work. Probably written in the 40s or 50s, maybe, from so far as we can tell. And not even sure it was submitted. It probably was submitted to a magazine, probably got rejected. But it's a poignant piece of work, and one of the few actual horror stories or supernatural stories that Bock wrote. So I'm going to use that. I have already accepted a story by John Hafley. Which is a Lovecraftian story, I confess. So this book doesn't exclude.
And it's
you know, John Hafley is a great advocate of August Derleth, and that's fine. I don't see eye to eye on him on that subject, but that's okay. But he has set this story in Derleth's Sac Prairie country in Wisconsin, but it has Lovecraftian elements and Smithian elements also. And it's a fine piece of work. So I read a draft of it. He wants to touch up the draft, but basically I know that I want to include that story. And I've sent out invitations to others. I will have to confess, I would prefer not to get unsolicited submissions for this book, because I've already sent out a lot of inquiries to established authors, and I don't know that I would have room to publish over the counter submissions, as it were. So don't send me anything. No offense. So that's coming. My prediction is, I will finish the compilation by next summer. The book will probably come out in spring of 2014, let's say. What else do I have on the menu? Here's something very interesting. I'm doing a whole lot of books for Jared Walters of Centipede Press. I've mentioned them before, and one of the ones I have mentioned is my large Cthulhu anthology called A Mountain Walked. And Jared Walters just told me the other day that the fine writer Patrick McGraw, not McGrath, McGraw, wants to write an original story for it. So I'm tickled at that thought. I think he wants to write a sort of takeoff of Rats in the Walls, which would be very nice. I think that's just the sort of thing that he could do very well. So I'm looking forward to seeing that in the next couple of months. I think that book is still scheduled for the summer, next summer, as is Black Wings 3. I'm hoping both will come out, August, let's say, maybe drag into September. Yes, I just heard, I think the newest PS Publishing newsletter, which came out, at least I got it today, finally announces my history of supernatural fiction called Unutterable Horror in 2 volumes. Expensive book, I'm afraid. Two hardcover volumes, two big hardcover volumes, each about 400 pages. But it'll be out. I think the publisher promises to have it out officially on Christmas Day, which is sort of ironic, because that reminds me of how Horace Walpole published The Castle of Otranto, the first Gothic novel, on Christmas Day of 1764. So, in some senses, that's appropriate. If you're looking for a paperback edition, I'm sorry to say you probably won't find one, because I will reprint it in my series of books for Scarecrow Press. It's called my series called Literature of the Supernatural. So that'll be the U.S. edition probably 18 months from now, but that'll also be a hardcover, because those books are generally designed for libraries. Maybe, actually, come to think of it, PS will probably issue an e-book edition, so at worst you can probably get an e-book edition and that should be good.
Look at Letters series.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I mean, I'm sure I've been telling you a lot about the Lovecraft Letters to Clark Ashton Smith, or rather the joint correspondence. Well, we kind of got bogged down on that, and we were trying to get it out this year. Obviously, that's not going to happen. What we've decided to do is get it out late next year, late 2013. We're going to do another volume, a shorter and somewhat less difficult volume to do. These are the letters... to Elizabeth Toldridge and Anne Tillery Renshaw. Not that there's any relation between those two people, aside from the fact they were women, but it's a convenient fit for us in terms of the size. So David Schultz and I are already done most of the annotation for that book. And I'll tell you what, that book will contain some of the last bit of unpublished Lovecraft prose outside of letters, namely the chapters that he wrote for Renshaw's wretched little book, Well-Bred Speech, in 1936. He wrote several whole chapters that she simply cut from the book when she, you know, when he sent it back to her. You know, maybe it was just too long or whatever. But those chapters still exist at the John Hay Library, and they're a little, I mean, I wouldn't say they're scintillating prose. They're mostly, you know, about word usage, and there's a whole thing about pronunciation, and there's stuff about bromides, which was a term for cliches back then. You know, don't use bromides, so he has a whole list of at least of cliches that you shouldn't have used. But I still think it's valuable stuff, and it shows how Lovecraft was really careful in terms of how much time he spent on this book. Of course, he also wrote that piece called, well, it came to be called Suggestions for a Reading Guide. It's a long, long list of books you should read from the great literature of the world. We won't reprint that because that's already in the second volume, Collected Essays, but you'll have three or four new chapters from this Well-Bred Speech book. So that could happen as early as the spring.
Did you mention your choir?
Oh, I didn't. We are today, this is Friday evening, December 7th. Tomorrow, December 8th, my choir, the Northwest Chorale, will be performing at a church here in Seattle. You can get the details at nwchorale.org. That's our first concert. We'll have another concert of the same works on December 15th, the next Saturday, at a different church. So find the details there. So any locals here watching, if you want to hear me sing,
well, we can hear you sing right now. Let's sing Silent Night.
Oh God!
Oh, come on, it's Christmas.
All right, maybe
this is our Christmas. Okay.
All right. So anyway,
just one verse.
Okay, we have 2.5 minutes left here. We'll do Silent Night. Silent night, holy night, all is calm.
Wonderful evening and a wonderful Yom Kippur and happy holidays, darling. Thank you, S.T. Joshi, my hero. My God. How do I do this? Oi. Stop.
Stop.
Stop. Stop.
Right.
Shalom.